हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ मिसेस प्रज्वल गायकवाड, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग, ऑल इंडिया श्री शिवाजी मेमोरियल सोसाइटीज इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी पुणे इज प्रेजेंटिंग यू डे टुडे यू द टॉपिक ऑफ फाइनाइट ऑटोमेटा बेसिक्स. सो व्हाट एक्चुअली फाइनाइट ऑटोमेटा इज, when you look at this diagram, finite automata can be represented as taking an input string. The finite automata processes that string and outputs a string. But when we want to represent this as a finite acceptor, the output changes. Here we can say that a finite automata takes an input, a string, and after processing that string, the finite automata can output as whether the string is accepted or rejected by the finite automata. We have to go through the formal definition of a deterministic finite acceptor or automata, we can say, to understand this. We can consider it as a machine or DFAM, which is having 5 tuples, Q, sigma, delta, Q0 and F. Q is the set of states, sigma is input alphabets, delta is transition function, Q0 is the initial state and F indicates set of final states. We'll go through an example to understand all these 5 tuples. So input alphabets are A and B. When you look at the diagram, it represents a DFA having 6 states, that are Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 and Q5. And when you look at the outgoing arrows from each state, on those arrows these input alphabets are written, which is A and B. No other alphabet is used in this diagram. So here sigma is A and B. Set of states is Q. So here, as I told you, the states are Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 and Q5, which are represented as a circle here, and every circle is having arrow incoming or outgoing, and onto that input alphabets are given. So the state, you can say that, is taking that input alphabets and making a transition to another state by consuming or by taking that input alphabet. So we start with the initial state. The first state is here Q0. Whenever an incoming edge is shown, like in this diagram, here it is, this one is Q0, which is the initial state. So we start here and we move forward by taking the input alphabets. And final state is represented with embedded circles. So here only one final state is there for this DFA, which is Q4. So Q0 is initial and Q4 is the final state. Now, how actually it makes transition, or the DFA makes transition? So the transition function is defined as Q across sigma, it gives Q. It means that you are taking a state with input alphabet, it makes a transition to another state or a state. For example, Q0 is a state which takes an input alphabet A, moves to state Q1. So this transition function defines transition function Q0A, which gives another state, or it moves to another state, which is Q1. So a transition is shown by consuming the input alphabet. Another example is Q0B. You can see that it moves to another state, that is Q Q5. Same way Q2B, it moves to Q3. So transition of Q2 comma B, that is input alphabet, it gives or moves to state Q3. So from other given DFA, what we can do is we can generate a transition table which represent all the transitions given in the DFA, that is like from which state by taking which alphabet it moves to which another state or whether it remains in the same state. So if we look at this transition table, the first column is showing the transition of, you are supposed to write all the states of the DFA. So the states written Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 and Q5. And the other two columns represent the input alphabet. This number of columns can increase depending on the number of input symbols. Here the input symbols are only two, that is A and B. So two columns are there. Now look at the transitions. So Q0A, so Q0A, it is moving to Q1. So the output is state Q1. Q0B, Q0B is moving to Q5. So the output is Q5. Q1A is Q5. Q1A is Q5. Q1B is Q2. Q2A is Q5. Q2B is Q3. Q3A is Q4, which is an accepting state. Q3B is Q5. Q4A is Q5. Q4B again is Q5. Q5A as well as B is itself the same state, Q5. So the closure, you can see, or the arrow to the same state indicate that the state remains in the same state by consuming these symbols, that are A and B for state Q5. So what we have studied today is all the tuples of the finite automata and how to write those 5 tuples for a given DFA. We have studied that with an example. So thank you.